Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC694MDL940 and also an IC694MDL645 or 646 if you have it. The purpose of this test was really for the IC694MDL940 16 point relay output, 24 volt DC. So if you don't have an MDL 645 or 646, I'll give you a quick description on how you can test it without an input. So what I've basically done here is I have a 16 point 24 volt DC output feeding its power to an IC694MDL 645 or 646 16 point 24 volt DC input. So when I power this and I turn a channel on, I should see a channel turn on in the input, okay? So what I have in front of you is the IC695 CHS007 seven slot rack, an IC695 PSA040 power supply, and the processor I'm using for this test is an IC695 CPU320. Other peripheral devices that I'm using for this test, or you will have to have for this test, is a 24 volt DC power supply. It's something that you can't see, but I have my leads going to it now, and it's already powered up. If you are using, as you can see, I have a preset terminal strip where the outputs go to the corresponding inputs, meaning output 1 goes to input 1, output 2 goes to input 2, and so on, as per the wiring diagrams on the MDL940s and MDL645 or 646. What I'm doing now, this doesn't really care how you wire your positive and negative as long as they're opposite each other. But what I've chosen to do on the diagram is to put my positive lead to terminal number 1. That'd be the top left terminal on the MDL645, 646 input. And to terminal 16 on the MDL940 output. Okay, so again, if you guys are deciding that you want to make a fixture so that you can test your inputs and outputs, you can do that. Now, if you don't have, if you're not using a fixture, what you can do with the relay output is you can check your wiring diagram. Okay, it's set up into four groups, and you put voltage positive where it's located, which would be screws 1, 6, 11, and 16. And then the negative, you can actually just leave loose, and you can touch each terminal with either a 24 volt relay, so you can hear it clicking on and off, or a 24 volt bulb, so you can see the light lighting up, or you could even use a multimeter, okay, like I have here, a Fluke multimeter that's reading 24 volt DC, or as close to it as possible. All right, so the next step is going to be in the software, of course. I'm using Proficy Machine Edition, and I'm going to connect up to the processor using a HE693 SNP CBL cable, and I'm going to use an HE693 SNP 232 connector in order to get to this COM port number 2. All right. Let me back up. That's an HE693 CBL232 cable attached to an HE693 SNP232 connector. And the reason I'm using a connector is because my COM port number 2 is a 15 pin, so I need to convert from 9 to 15 pin. So the first thing that I want to do is connect up to the processor by hitting the lightning bolt icon. And then the green handprint icon, which is the toggle into online mode. All right, and you can see all these open up and highlight. Now, if you look down below, if you follow my arrow, you can see that the mode that we're in right now, or the status, is programmer mode, stop, disabled, configuration, and logic are not equal. That's because this processor was doing something different than what we're asking it to do today, the last time it was being used. So in slot number 0 and 1 is my PSA040 power supply. It's using two slots. Slot number 2 and 3 is my CPU320, is using slots 2 and 3. Leaves me with slots 4, 5, and 6 open. And slot 4, if you right click or double click and hit add module, go to discrete output, And nearly the bottom selection, you'll see the IC694MDL940. There's no settings per se on this, but what you do want to note is the reference address, so that when we go to the output table, you know that it's output 00001 for channel 1, and then subsequently after that, all the other 16 channels will follow that. Channels 0002, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. And slot number 5, again, right-click or double-click, add module, discrete input, IC694MDL645, or like I told you guys, you can use a 646. Okay. And same thing, if you do want to see the reference address, if you want to see the inputs, just note that it's going to start on reference address number 1 on the input table. All right. Next thing I want to do is go to target. As I said before, logic and configuration are not equal. So what we'll need to do is go to clear. And we're going to clear controller fault and IO fault tables. And again, that's because the processor was doing something different before. And then we're going to click download and run. We're going to download this configuration, which is just a hardware configuration. So when the software asks us exactly what do we want to download to the processor, how much information, it's just hardware configuration, motion, and logic. We don't want to write anything to permanent flash memory or anything like that. Basically, with this test is very simple. This is a discrete output. So these points, these 16 points, are either just on or off, and that's what we want to check. So again, as I said before, if you guys want to use a bulb or a multimeter or a relay, a solenoid, something like that you can hear clicking on and off, that's fine. What I do recommend, though, is that you make sure that the outputs, when they're shut off, are truly in the off mode. So go ahead and turn all your outputs on, test it with your bulb or your multimeter, whatever you have, then go back and shut all your outputs off and retest it to make sure that none of them are still on. That's usually the most common problem I see with a failed output. Right? Now we're in run mode, as you can see. And down below, programmer mode, run enabled, configuration and logic equal. We're going to open up our default tables and go to output. And we're going to toggle the bits from a 0 to a 1 and hit enter. And you're going to hear a clicking noise when each of these relays are being turned on, because they're a mechanical switch is what they really are. So if you don't hear a click and a light doesn't come on, pretty obvious that that's not a working unit. Okay. All right. So if you look at the two discrete output and input that I have in front of you right now, you can see all 16 of my channels are on. They're lit up on the output, and all 16 channels are on and lit up on the input. And that means that the 24 volts that is required to turn on my inputs on a MDL645 or 646 are, you know, completely turned on and in good working condition. So if I had any of these lights on my output, but the light wasn't on the input, that means that there could be a problem with your wiring, but more likely it has to do with the output not putting any power on to the terminal, okay? So please note that, and you'll be able to see where your problem is too. So if it says number 14 or number 6 or number 5 are off, then that means 14, 6, or 5 are not working on your output card, okay? So as I said before, what we're going to do is shut these off. And I want to make sure I see all these go off. Okay. Now, if there was a problem and I have everything wired up and powered on, my 24 volt power supply powered on, and any of these circuits were stuck on with the method I'm using to test this, I would have already seen that some of the circuits are in the on position. That means that the mechanical switch is stuck in the closed position. Okay. It would be a little bit different for you guys out there that have any of the other test parts, like a multimeter or a light like we described before. You're going to actually need to probe each channel to make sure that they're either working or not working, or if they're able to be shut off or not. Okay. So if you guys have any problems with your MDL940, or if you've done this test and you know what the problem is, this is something that we commonly repair here at PDF Supply. And we keep a lot of these cards in stock at all times. We have exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something you guys need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.